Wow, I did all of that? The thermometer? I haven't even started thinking about that one yet. Mamma mia, pizza pie, I got a lot to do. I better get it going. Wait a minute, this is my house. Maybe you better get it going, huh?
Okay, see you all later. Bye, Galileo!
Wow, we just met Galileo!
Yes, and he played a big part in mankind's history.
Along with many others.
Mathematicians, astronomers, and scientists shared and learned from each other's written works to come up with new and better discoveries.
For example, the ideas of Ptolemy, Copernicus, Tycho Brahe, Galileo, and Kepler all led to Newton's theory of universal gravity.
Newton's theory of universal gravity. Every object in the universe attracts every other object with a force directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the centers of mass of the two objects.
Later on, Einstein's theory of general relativity used the curvature of space and the flow of time to help explain the movement of the planets.
Wow, the ideas grew and grew by sharing.
They evolved from contributions by many different people.
I'm gonna come up with some new discoveries, too.
Me, too.
Yeah,
I'm gonna be part of history, too.
You can all be part of history.
Let's continue our trip.
Let's dive into times!
What's 10 times 10?
100!
It's raining.
I'm getting cold.
Hey, look, someone's flying a kite.
It's Benjamin Franklin!
Well, hello! Did you know that lightning is actually electricity?
Yes!
Shocking, isn't it?
We better get inside!
Ah, yes, kids. You must be careful with electricity. It can be extremely dangerous. Oops! I just dropped my bifocal glasses.
Hey, didn't you invent bifocals?
Why, yes, I did. I have invented many things, like swimming fins, the Benjamin Franklin stove, and even the lightning rod.
What is a lightning rod?
A lightning rod is a long pole made of iron that is used to protect buildings and homes from dangerous lightning strikes.
What a great invention.
Speaking of great inventions, what is that instrument you're playing, Mr. I?
It's an electric guitar.
An electric guitar? Did you invent that?
No, I didn't invent it myself, but I can play it.
You know, kids, electricity is the flow of electrons from one atom to another. It all began with the discovery of static electricity many thousands of years ago.
Around 600 BC, Greeks discovered that by rubbing a fossilized resin known as amber against a fur cloth, they could attract small pieces of straw. In 1820, Hans Christian Ørsted from Denmark noticed the needle of a compass moved when put near an electric current. This led to the principle of electromagnetism.
Electromagnetism, one of four fundamental forces, is the physics of the electromagnetic field that encompasses all of space. This field is made up of the electric field and the magnetic field. Electric currents traveling along a wire produce magnetic forces called an electromagnet. The rotation of magnets around a wire produce electricity. This force binds negatively charged electrons to each positively charged nucleus.
So electricity and magnetism are related?
Very much so.
Mathematically so as well.
You can make a magnet from electricity. An electromagnet.
And you can make electricity from a magnet.
Wow!
Discoveries in electricity continued, and many inventions were created that use electricity and the force of electromagnetism.
Mr. Franklin, would you care to join us in a song about electricity?
That would be splendid.